around the world. They consider to do so. Now they're known. The problems are arising as from many angles. The Alliance players are coming in. AslaN is starting off good with that. But the shock dart should hit the planter. That's the case. Gobstead, this is a good bit of an electrifying performance from Fearoth. As we're heading into a 4v3 with Alliance having the upper hand on this scenario. Flashbang is going to come in. Twisten and his mate gotta see where they end up. There has to be the first little sticking. But Kaspe needs to hit the shots right now, because otherwise he might be out of the equation. He is. Same goes for Obnoks. And there's no paint shell, no opportunity. One little info dart to get out of there. And the Lions are picking up the first. And support his players back on the side. He is aware of those little flanks and lurks. Twisten is not gonna survive that, is he? He still remains alive. Fearoth, just at 11 HP, is gonna die off that bot. And that did not go according to plan. But the frags are still happening. I'm still holding on to it. He still says, this is our home. This is our town. You're not letting us get away from the site. And there's one after another falling. The right
plant.
Exactly. Yeah, well, not for God, but he still finds the tiniest edge and tiniest bit. But there, it is. I'm taking it back. Beautiful movement. Kaspe, you're out of there. Save that rifleman.
This is amazing coming in from Alliance, just respecting the times, also not being
blinded. Their patient approach is going to work out, as to put it. He's out of the equation already. Same goes for Obnoks. Those pistols don't work, but I mean, it's just pistols. At least one killed. Wait. One of the most talented players with Big, that is Twisten. He was not flourishing as much as we know him so far, but that is because AslaN sometimes stole the show, but here it is. Good stuff. Hitting the first. Hype is being taken out. The A side is weak in a slight bit, but it's still not much time left. We're talking about 15 seconds, and every bit of utility that is holding you up from a plant is becoming a problem. But Gob's getting that thing down. Spike hits the ground. And suddenly, Zik is closer than expected. The Molly's coming in as well. Gob gotta go, and Gob's staying alive. The man is low on HP, but he's running, and he's running fast to make it work. Spotted as well. Sider might just have a free frag. If Gob is not reacting in time, to his left, he gotta check. He knows he's just around the corner, and he's beheading the IGL from Journey, which leaves us down to only two on the big side. But Sider has proved in the past what he can do. Knows that there's one towards Spa, fakes it once. Both players are HP-wise not looking too ideal as he swings. Kaspe is in full control of the... that's for sure not the case. I'm with you on that, but... It's right now, the defenders already are deep down,
oh my God.
The attack is spawned. Gops out, and luckeRRR was just running a marathon to make that work, as he's getting one after another. Spike delivered. Okay. All for you, luckeRRR.
He has the spike, he has the operator on that. This is a different way to see a Raze play the operator. It works for me. Remaining. Hype just finding Kaspe here. And that is...
I see somebody's close by. Smoke as well. He takes him out in time. Too eager from Sider. Smoke would have popped. He would have been fully in safety. But now Alliance, gotta see where they land here, because there's a lot of big players in front of the side. Good old Twisten's already out. So he tries to take the high ground, but that ain't happening. The good part about all of this is... there's still an ult available. But, oh, that might just not be working anymore.
No, not at all. I mean, he's complete. This is not a good position for him, is it?
Absolutely blind. Yeah. Absolutely dead.
I cannot only overtime strike.
Yeah, and the Molotov's coming in. Oh, well, Twisten's out already, so it's time to find more and more. But he's awaiting what's happening. Sider's getting ready for it. It's not going to be fast enough. Obnoks is just going to get out of there. He's going to land in the corner. He's not dead. Nobody off Big has taken any damage off of that. The orbital strike not working according to plan. Sider falling as well. And those things aren't looking too good anymore for Alliance, as it was decently fortified. One after another's fallen. Hype's out of that as well, and he's running for his life.
Also hear the spike going down. It could be a bait. But you know, the position has already been taken onto B. You've heard that. Damage.
Well, enough damage coming also out of it. As well as Fearoth are waiting back on time to invite the players to go a little too far. Fearoth is starting that show perfectly. As a drone from Gob tries to tag him, that ain't happening. So they enter the site. The thing is that they're now getting a lot of damage on those big players. They're holding up them a lot of time to get the third player on board. He sees Gob! The sheriff's back in town, and you better get out of here.
They rotate over to A, even though they have the time.
No!
It's too risky.
And it's done! Towards the taking out Kaspe. One down, and this is such a classic move of Gob. and his poison. Ah, this is smart from luckeRRR. Is he hitting the timing? No, he might just be dead. He is. Toxin laying on the ground, so you can't exit from that. That's solid stuff, but they still... But once they trigger it, it's becoming a problem. So... Patience is key.
Yes.
He's very deep in it. He's scared of any kind of flanks right now. Here comes the first, tries to bait it out. Obnoks is winning the fight as well. And suddenly, SEIDER is going to be tacked about it as well. They know where the players remaining are. And as Fearoth is now going to be found, it's time to swing. It is time to swing.
Also careful enough to deny some of the angles walking onto A.
luckeRRR is a madman, but he's getting punished. No, not this time around. I've got a chance. Does not take him out. For a second, it looked dangerous, but Twisten.
He's been completely decisive at the beginning of the match.
Pretty much the case.
He knows. He knows.
He's really holding that? Oh my goodness. That is.
AslaN has been playing in the same position for 2 matches, but he's still amazing!
It's confidence! But unfortunately, he can't make that frag work. Brilliant stuff by SEIDER going for. The good part is that if you bait out once, when Gop will get the plant, he will have Hunter's Fury. So he's getting him out of there, alright. Bit of time won, but it's not too much. If he still makes that work... Fearoth is a problem. 10 seconds. You gotta do something. He's not looking behind. And he's taking him out. This is not possible. It should not be possible for Obnoks. And it won't be possible.
Exactly. As I said, it's everything to this shorty. There's only one thing that you can do.
Getting close, but low HP he is. No, Twisted is not a part of his show. So. Coming close to the side. Knowledge. Massive information gained by just that dart, but Twisten's falling. Same goes for AslaN.
Spike planted.
As Obnoks is quite eager to make a move through. Skop, as well as Kaspe, who can make a change. Going for the right click, at least things won. And we saw Kaspe clutch out incredible rounds in the past. Now he has been spotted by the guiding light that's coming close. Big problem going lamps. There's a double barrel just waiting for him. Yeah. Yep. That thing's gonna be annoying. For both sides, too many players await him. Sick!
For Alliance. Perfect range. A good exit here around it.
Oh, you're right. He's getting Obnoks early. Twisten is welcoming luckeRRR with a taste of his own medicine.
What is that?
He got the antidote ready. Nice try, luckeRRR. But I can play that better. So it's a 4v4. Set up towards B is though coming in.
That was disgusting. Must be here waiting. Dear lord.
He can even escape. The man's bunny hoping away. He's waiting in guard and hope that anyone is coming towards him. He's like...
He still does the damage.
Exactly. It's problematic and big make it work. This could be a 50 going their way.
No.
Not again. Not again. Oh, this was a little too much. It was a little scary. He still makes a move. Oh, this is going to be very inaccurate. And he's like, Twisten, help me, man. He got...
Molly. Utility falling onto Blaze, but... Oh, here comes the follow-up.
Frags are there. And so they're entering. SEIDER. It's looking where to come with that. I still... Kaspe waits. Hype is having a feeling about it. He's like, I'm having none. I really don't need this. And as he's tanking him once, I'm running away. Really, I don't need any of this.
It's the best that could happen to you. He can keep it for the next round. We're not gonna... I thought for a second that he would have the kill there, and then...
Flying in there
is a lot.
It is massive. There's a spy going down with the ways. AslaN is putting his DPI up for a second. And suddenly, an ult lands nowhere. Very eager to put that thing down. It didn't see SEIDER coming that close over lamb. Spike's gonna hit the ground any second soon. Skop still retreats, has been spotted, Twisted alive.
30 seconds left.
He could be a pivotal piece in the puzzle right now for the big side of things. They want to keep up with the lead, because otherwise Alliance will snatch it. With the spike down, it very much looks doable for the big A, but as Obnoks is finding Fearoth, we're back in it. Viper Spit doesn't make it easier. Twist and careful where the opponents are awaiting him as he swaps back to the Vandal. SEIDER finding himself a triple. The quad possibly with the
Shklet. Would have exploded like a popcorn.
I haven't had popcorn in a while. Good reminder. Thank you very much for that one, Via.
Now Gop. It's really good.
I know. I'm with you on that. For now, AslaN needs to get out of there. Kaspe is helping him with that as they find two frags. Big is once more coming in with a not-so-complete buy and make it look like it's the easiest task of the world. Lucker picks up the spike again, but from so many angles, the big players are trying to come in as they still look for the kills. Kaspe is starting off, getting fear off. So he takes a turn around to the other side. No chance for Sig. And luckeRRR left with a task that should be impossible. Nobody, not even the demigods of Valorant, should be capable of doing so. He starts up good, Gob is down, goes in the tube, spikes going hitting the ground. It's just impossible. Just impossible for him. The team was doubted many times in the past. They definitely make a name for themselves. And the same goes for Alliance. The team hasn't had many impressive showings in 2021. They are a name to be remembered, but Twisten is going for the same.
Oh my god, he died from
the sneak
fire! Oh, it's good! Combined with a brimstone smoke. The same price.
So luckeRRR, jumping onto the site. Going elbow already to take a bit of a different territory. There it is. Stick down. Obnoks eliminated, forcing him out of the angle. Bob's just holding it. Blades back in hookah, which it did not clear, so he hopes for the right timing. Good shock dart number one. Actually not. He's back in tube. Now he's taking the damage. And that makes him feel
hitting the smoke in place, it was more important.
Yeah, that one is placed as well. So at that point, Fearoth is having a time of his life. He's finding it. Oh, SEIDER!
What?
Is there with again. The triple hype is joining.
How big the economy is on this one, but Alliance is two rounds away from just taking their pick.
Snap. Here it goes. Seems like it's an A-side attack. And talking about luckeRRR, he's out. Be an option to go for. Talking about 25, by the way. We're talking about a well-placed nade dead. That's killing hype. God. Yep, spike carrier killed. That's a big red bar on top of your screen that's saying what's happening, but it doesn't seem to really stop them. Twisted gotta be careful as he's being wall-banged from every direction. The spike still hitting the ground. They had a 5v3 at their hands, but others remain on site. Gotta be Kaspe and Obnoks. You're still looking to find those kills. The flash to let this man into lambs will be helpful as he finds one!
Oh,
Kaspe has proven that he's most definitely the judge. He's speaking the verdict. He's coming in. He's trying to defuse. And he's now has been spotted. He's trying to see when can he bait out Fearoth. Goes for the first fake. Gotta make a move, Kaspe. You can't just stick it. That's not okay. He keeps on sticking. He has halved it. When is Fearoth finally doing something? There he goes! Look at his HP! He's going on! He's going on!
Oh my god!
But the decision wasn't right!
Can we talk about... I'm not gonna say the sentence that I was going to say, but that was ballsy, okay? That was out of the world. The fact that you cannot hear a thing and you just trust in your gut until that...
I've
got your trail.
Quite sure, but Obnoks most definitely is. So SEIDER takes out. Couldn't escape in time. Kaspe's trying his best long range with that shotgun. The ninja himself, named luckeRRR, knocking on the back door. Says, how many can I grab this time? Wow. Pretty much everyone. This site belongs to me. And we might just have a map number one decided. Could be a finish. Miracle we're seeing. I do not believe in it very much. Alliance really pulled this one back, all in their favor. It was a tied up half, and now they're succeeding over... You know what? I'm gonna like it anyway. It is going to be the SEIDER who's gonna make it in the lower bracket final, where one of the two slots for VCT EMEA 2022 Europe is gonna be given away. Big are on the verge of being eliminated, and Alliance is stepping a step further, but AslaN talking about getting a step closer. Together with Twisten, they find a kill after another. The man is sneaky, moving for the smoke like a ninja. But it's a 2v2, and Alliance still can get the spike down over there and beat.
I still need to retrieve it. They don't feel safe enough. The good thing is that Hype's still alive. Remaining. They do have that vape.
They must. No way that they don't have that on the radar. Finds the first, the second ain't granted. Oh, this just gotta close as hell.
Gotta find the same flow. Yeah.
Well, Big changed something. Alliance most likely not expecting that to be the case.
Yeah, he was spotted. He doesn't have the room. It's just too risky. But AslaN is taking place here. But look at where Hype is.
Yeah, that's
Jesus.
Massive.
Big didn't notice, and I didn't either, to be fair.
Last player standing.
Okay.
Well,
that's nasty.
And And this is where you have no Killjoy, right? Killjoy being on the battlefield. So big. We've got themselves to most likely not catch a fern. They won't. Obnoks actively engaging into a combat there in middle, but Twisten finds the first. Swaps back. So Alliance will set the pace to get over on site. Kaspe is a little overwhelmed with what's happening towards him. And all those frags from Hype pay off. If Gomp doesn't hit the timing, he does to a certain degree, but Hype ain't dead, which means there's still a good chance. I didn't even say it. No word. No, I didn't say it.
Here's all that space. Everything's cleared. On one side of the smoke, though.
Oh, that's big. On one side of the smoke. Zix is very ambitious. So the Dane is trying his best to make it work. He's gonna die. Spike's down, but other than that, it's a good disadvantage for Alliance. They most likely can't come out of this as a victor, and if they do, they won't be sure what they're made of. As though AslaN swings wide, finds one, can't obtain the second. It's only a Fearoth who could stand a chance. He won't. Here we go.
But AslaN here defending on green is almost impossible.
And this is where you have the perfect play with the Reyna, because you have so much cover you can move back to AslaN. Showing why he used to be a duelist, as he finds one after another.
Different composition, because it's not like a massive change, but I feel like it has nothing to do.
Exactly, no, that's the thing, right? They seem to be a little bit swapped out in that sense. Now Twisten is up, can't afford a whiff, won't do so. Brilliant stuff from the Czech all player. It brings them with a double man advantage. Sure, Alliance, they have themselves a Bladestorm. They have themselves a Hunter's Fury, but everything will not be put to use as Obnoks is looking for another duel to then possibly dismiss. Luckeer's not even taking a look around because too many targets are on his radar. And is it going to be a flawless brought to you by Kakuka? Nope, it won't be. Six actually coming in with a double. And now I'm starting to get a little bit afraid here for Big. And immediately, the thing hits the ground, the timer starts. Obnoks now also coming back. He knows that there's an operator just nearby. And as he's taking that swing, he knows he's reloading. One player found 16 bullets as well. It's not possible. It's not allowed to be possible. Oh, yeah. Let's hope that is not happening, because they have been delivering a great peace of mind. For now, it's not looking too good over here on Icebox. Obnoks is waiting to find more. Brilliant reaction. Combination with Gob's abilities again. As he's
Why are you peeking?
Yeah, why are you... That's your question.
It was so beautiful.
Well, either way, Gob can't escape.
He gotta make
time.
My mistake. Spike planted.
As Aslan is looking around. Totally. Got the rifle in hand. Okay, it's a Twisten show. Let's start this. Right inside, you gotta check. And that one goes up. A good hit. Getting another one. AslaN definitely tagged. As it is, 55 seconds. AslaN taking a major risk. AslaN finding a major frag, but instantly being traded. They could still move around. They could still change positions, still change directions.
Watching.
They won't do so. Twisten is looking around it. And just on the edge of the smoke, he was caught off guard. And so it's only two big players remaining. Gopping Obnoks, the German duo that stands a chance! Oh, how can you be so unlucky is the question. Gops, they're on a chance. No real big chance. As he still gets lucky. Totally, I mean, luckeRRR is definitely doing a decent job. Same goes for Obnoks. Finds two, is out of that space. And he even survives. Twisten's coming in as well. And the duelist duo are obtaining three kills already. It's an absolute match show we're witnessing. But it's... Look behind him, there's gonna be a bit of a pincer move! He still gets Hype at least. This was so important! As back for CT side to realize what's gonna happen. He's overhealed, sees one, tries to make anything work. Kaspe in the corner trapped, and possibly killed. This is not good for Big. Kaspe got it under control.
That could have been the-
Just a little bit. He went into full beast mode with Obnoks as well as Twist. But as I close my mouth, it's dead.
The Empress comes into play.
There you go.
Okay.
As well, the problems arise. The Gob's still on it. There comes the dart. Getting a bit of a heal. He knows there's just one underneath, but he can pick it up. Someone gotta do something now. They don't know what's coming behind them. They don't know what's coming behind them. He might have just heard him. There comes the snake bite. Kaspe's starting to halve it. Kaspe is still not dead, but it's bringing it only down to Gob. So, alright. I mean, ouch. That's annoying. Oh, that's more annoying.
God.
Gasp is on me. Turn around, mate. Oh my god. No. Oh, that got too risky. If he would have pulled that off. Ice cold, man's finish, of course. I mean, that's in his veins, but
healing.
Heal's coming in.
So good to have the Sage and have that heal. Oh, no. Oh.
Awkward duel, still making it work. Takes a few years to get that one destroyed. And now Gop is playing Ring Around the Rosie, bringing it down to one low HP Viper. As there is no further peaks, Twisted still makes it work. And as they move over to the B side.
Oh, hi. It's not looking good for you, my friend. Never mind! Smoke this rune again!
There we go.
It's a tricky one. Either way.
Now we're gonna jinx it for you as Twisted dies as well.
I love jinxing.
You do a great job in it, really. That works fine, but Gop is really angry. Takes down luckeRRR. Four more remain to get that retake going, and that motor, that engine, is being fired up as they finally hit those RPMs to get it back onto the side. Kaspe has to make a move, and he swings. Might be known, still finds kills. But SEIDER is not necessarily on the radar, as he still gets one. He does.
Okay.
Leaves it to Gop, and the wall... Oh. It's not gonna make it work. Nothing is there for him. They take the round. They take the damn round. Luck is taking the swing. Can't do it.
And the Viper's holds.
Yep, indeed. Hits out. Trying to play off of that. Six considers, but here they go. Deep down spawn. Now it's about buying time. Now it's about Twisten do it. And he's going to be the guys. Oh no. SEIDER. Good wall. He's saving his life. Our Kaspe with the right move. Obnoks with his death. Spikes on the ground. But a free versus free. This is the round that could be the game changer right here. Bjor Twister needs to be checked. Won't be the case. And so only Kaspe has a chance.
You know
he finds another. He does not check that. It's a bit unbelievable. And so two duelists now need to fight it out in one versus one. He saw a bit. Twisten, you gotta stay confident. You gotta keep those nerves of steel. Step in loudly, baiting him out once, trying to see where he ends up with it. But SEIDER takes it home, and it would have been the round.
Really, also already invested, and they're finding the kills.
Here. Yeah. Ooh, actually, all around the map they do. He's even blind. Aslan's not even looking and gets the kill. Nobody's coming for two. That's his luck. But oh no, the time is on. That's gonna be the 11th. It should be the 11th, but still someone is blows around to smoke. That
hype
is
just there.
It's gonna be killed as well. The money is gonna be so crucial the next round. If the boys are not working that one out. Oh, this is problematic for Bic. Oh, this is uncomfortable for Bic. Kasper's not even checking. Oh, luckeRRR is doing luckeRRR things. They're starting to stick it. That plant is never so favorable. He's going on. Second dart needs to hit. He's going on. luckeRRR ain't stopping that.
Last player standing.
And you still gotta deny it. AslaN make a move, but he can't. This was
not enough. And I was thinking that probably he was going to be hype, getting at least one or two playing from inside the smoke and probably be unpredictable, but no.
It feels like Vic can get on the side quite well when they are playing fast, but the problem is that from that point on, they start to struggle with the afterplan scenarios because it's not that well structured. Spike got a pick, by the way. Vic's getting attacked by the drone again. AslaN's considering who's gonna make the pick. That's the question. As he uses his ult, should be safe. Just running in. He says running in. But AslaN's dead. AslaN is dead. Oh no! Don't do it. Don't make this work. Hype's still on it. Four bullets left in the mag. As he's looking for more and more, Gop's denying. So it's like, the bouncer says, you're not coming in here. luckeRRR on 30 points of health, will have a tough time, and still, he's trying his best. It's eliminated. Same goes for Twisted. Long range duel with Fearoth pays off as suddenly AslaN takes a bit of risk. He's not being attacked. He has not been found millimeters away. Hunter's Fury, and he still finds another. Sick falls. It's all collapsing. Alliance do not stand a chance in this round. It's only one player, and that will be Hype. But it ain't happening. It should not be happening. It would be the clutch of his lifetime, and so there we go. And as he's trying to find a bit more, Gop's not showing himself the slightest bit. He's not even moving around it. There's the info dart. It's not going to find anyone. And so the time most likely is going to work against him anyway. One kill, but that's it. Number 12 is there.
I mean, he's still going to be able to light shields, but this is map point for them. This is probably a one-way ticket onto Ascent, as Alliance needs four rounds in a row to even take this to overtime.
Right here.
By how big has been possible.
Here we start. AslaN picking up two. Naz, those frags are coming in. Slim chances for Alliance. It's still an Empress that could be brought in, but with a pistol at hand, it's most definitely not ideal. So the drone is hoping to gain a bit more information. Spotted one. There's the one from Gop coming in. They now know where three players are. They still find the kills. And as those deaths are happening on the side of Alliance, that should be done. That should be dusted. There is no universe. Or there should be no universe. Well, this is working out for the side of Alliance. This Gop is whiffing. It's only hype. As he's coming through, still gets a kill. It's crazy. This game is becoming crazy.
Oh my god.
And that with low so HP.
Alliance coming in strong. All the util coming down. Oh, Black already dashing onto side. He's gonna expect Gop to be there.
That's brutal utility. Kaspe is chiming in. The side is becoming a problem. SB is absolutely unobtainable for Alliance. Frag after frag found. Fearoth still tries his best. But with 15 points of health, he should not stand a chance. Kaspe is whiffing. But the rest of the boys seems to be the case, as Twisten is on the edge of moving out of there. But being confident is very surprising, seemingly. And that's the shock dart. Off, could do major damage! Hype ain't that by that. Alright, not 100% why, but let it be, as we all know. So, Gop is trying his best, gets Lucker down. The side is not under full control. It was exceptional support, but it's not done yet. As it leaves it down with two. Sick is keen to find those kills. Gop tries to swing, baits it out, and he waits for Kaspe to assist. In time.
The side utility is there, and here comes it.
You should run.
Suppressing everybody.
This is so good. Because they are expecting that they're expecting that Cypher's on the B site! They're expecting that Cypher's on the B site, but he's not! He's not even slightly debuffed by what is coming here from the ult off KO. They're getting the spike down, they're gonna lose another player, six out of the equation. And so Hype gotta see where he's ending up with his teammate. Nice ult that Fearoth could bring to the table, but it ain't happening. And that means one soldier stands there in the mud and tries his best, but go
very soon. And he's back up. Even though he's not tagged.
Good stuff.
This moment.
He might be keen to use the ult. Obnoks nearly with him, but backs off in time. Room open. He didn't check.
Finished. Oh, I would be so pissed, but nice movement there from Hype. Not walking on his own, and now the site is clear.
30 seconds left.
Maybe an unorthodox play, but...
And so the first one goes there. Alliance finally succeeding. After it took a good bit. So, a wonderful ult brings down Fearoth. Counterpart. Here's one step at least. Nose Jet is around. Flashbang. Here comes the flash. How many kills does he get? None! Okay, taking it back. It's at least one Obnoks. You gotta do something, mate! Oh, this was well played. In combination with the utility. That's annoying. That's really problematic. As they're starting to become... And that's risky. That's his death.
Again. Also, because you know that Gobby is going to be just by not taking anything, getting anything out of that drone. Oh, and the cosmic divide comes in.
Oh, spike down
that's good.
A.
Divide. This. Rushing in too soon.
True. It's sometimes just not so easy to time for some, which is very interesting. Talking about timing, unfortunate one there for Obnoks is one kill after another goes over the guys of Alliance, all in their favor. And again. Gop and Twisten gotta reconsider if they want to make a move right here.
Maybe, who knows? This list worth trying.
B, as they try to find at least one. Yep, that was good. Oh, Twisten having a tough time. No scope's not gonna be hit, and so luckeRRR is taking out Another jet of the other team, but Gop's timing's on point, but only for one. The SEIDER is ready and aware of such a situation happening. And so do you dare? Do you risk? Well, you can't anymore, really. This one should be done.
Done and done.
That's true. Oh, for spot again. They cannot cope with their info dodge right now. Twisten's not hitting the shot, and Obnoks, it's basically their savior right now, as though he's being traded at least.
Get out of my way!
Makes it a 4 versus 4. Daggers are out, though. The A side once more seems to be the main objective for the side of Alliance.
Spike down. That's the A pigeon shooting!
Well, seems like the Olympics are coming around the corner. He's just trying to practice, but Twisted and Cole, the best they can do is probably practice running, and they have to run a mile later on if they want to make this easy. Twisted's out. So, he's gotta be out.
Here's just going for the open.
Oh no! No way, they're lining up! What are the odds? I see where you're coming from with that.
Mm-hmm.
It's not nice. It's definitely not nice. luckeRRR feels confident, taking swings, taking peeks. Kasper's getting killed for the smoke, and a shorty's coming out luckeRRR. As well. Don't be that disrespectful, luckeRRR. Do us the favor.
Please do like it.
Yeah, of course. You're
please be disrespectful.
Shrapnel couldn't just step up in his face. AslaN's trying to use his wall, but see you later, Ring. Please make a lot of noise. Keep them distracted. But Kasper's looking behind, and suddenly it's all gone. All the distraction, all the opportunities. luckeRRR has been running for hours, but he still doesn't find a thing. Which leaves it down to Hype with 2 points of health. There is no way he's gonna do that. There is not a scenario where this is gonna be given away. And even through a smoke, through a cyber cage, AslaN getting this. So, as Big fixed a lot of things on Icebox, maybe the same thing goes for this, but as I...
You know when there's a lot in stake.
Yeah, there's a lot of pressure, and Hype knows how to deal with pressure. The guy was already good in Icebox, he keeps on performing and performing. As he changed positions, should be an easy one here for Big, and he is, as the flashbangs from Obnoks work brilliantly. AslaN and his lurking, you gotta keep that in mind, he's gonna do that quite often. Well, in the end, still, they're keen to do the fight. First one drops down. They do not check wine. Oh, goodness, he makes it through. He's still there with bow and arrow. It's getting crazy.
Get him up.
Goodness. They do get the guy back up.
And they decide to leave.
One down. We're ending up in a game that seems absolutely...
Especially one enemy remaining. No window.
Please, that has to stop, really. At least one gets himself. Could deal more economic damage, but from the back, already another one comes. Kaspe! Oh my goodness, this is good damage he deals. The round might not be secured.
He's not gonna check his back. He's not gonna check his back.
But he's already gone. That can't be happening.
He saw
the barrel.
He saw him.
He's not gonna do.
What?
Gops in. Look at the awkward position Gops in. He can't really use it. He's gonna be detained. He's gonna be detained. He can't do anything. They have no idea where he is. They're gonna still look for him, will they? Gop is not alive anymore. Alright, for a second I was just a little scared, but the fight diffuser has been killed. In the smoke! The man's in the smoke! We gotta shoot through! But Fearoth is stopping because he can't get that thing done! I wouldn't be surprised if we're running into overtime for now. It's Twisted. Realizing something's close. Nice try, luckeRRR. Oh, goodness. He's killing his teammate. No way.
I know.
It's only two remaining for Big. And Twist and Dice for Gob. This is a disaster for Berlin International Gaming.
The entire series. We're not there to witness it.
Cage trigger.
Here we go. Kasper's leaking out.
In all those corners. He knows that luckeRRR was playing on market.
Oh.
My dear lord.
He still gets it. Problems start becoming bigger. He knows luckeRRR's around. He whiffs that insane stuff. Kasper single-handedly trying to save the day right here for Big. They're swapping over. B-side is clear. Why would we contest A?
Yeah, totally. I mean, Three men, just himself.
Oh, but if he's getting those two, it's gonna be enough time. It's gonna be enough time, but he does not.
Too late, but do not forget that Big still needs to close up this map to take this serious. And of course, an overtime is still a possibility. Yeah. We see that the money is not the best. Shinobi is going to have enough.
Also has two exceptional ults on their side. So there, this was my personal oh no moment. AslaN out. Astra eliminated. Crucial utility that cannot be placed. And Sick is not going to be rewarded for his patience. Unfortunate for him. Alliance would still have a Hunter's Fury to get it out in case they need to. And they will.
Coming in, but not finding much. It's gonna be delayed just a little bit. Liger's gonna be
qualifying instantly for our qualifier number one. As all the information has been gained, Kaspe is playing around his own cage, but it is dead. So there's the man disadvantage. Free players are hiding just down there, and free players have gotta make it work. Obnoks are starting good! Big has the man advantage, and Hype gonna do it all! Nearly!